Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today I'm going to show you how to adjust the valves on our 2003 Honda Rancher 350. Pretty simple to do, as you can tell. The seat and some of the plastics are already out of the way. All that's left is just to get the fuel tank and this little plastic cover out of the machine. So let me go grab a couple of tools and I'll show you how to get it done. All right, this is going to be a skill level one, so it's really not going to be that tough. As far as the tools that you're going to need a couple of different ratchets. I prefer to have a 3/8 and a 1/4 inch on hand with various different extensions. It just makes life easier. As far as the individual sockets, 10 millimeter, a socket for the spark plug, and then a 6 millimeter Allen for an inspection port on the side of the engine. Other than that, a couple of basic screwdrivers, just a Phillips and a flathead, a 10 millimeter wrench, a pair of needle nose pliers, a pair of side cutters, flashlight, a decent torque wrench, and most importantly, a good set of feeler gauges. So once you have all your tools together, we can go over to the machine and I can show you just how easy this really is. All right, first order of business. Whenever you're gonna be opening up fuel system, go ahead and disconnect the battery. Typically, I just pull the negative side. All right, with that disconnected, let's go and get this plastic intake for the airbox out of the way. It's just the clamp down at the airbox itself, and then one of those plastic rivets over here on the side. With that, you just wiggle it out. Next, let's go ahead and turn the fuel off. And when you do that, your valve's actually gonna be halfway. And then there's just a Phillips up in there that you have to unscrew, and then the entire arm will pull right off. Next, the fuel tank is only held down by 3 10 millimeter bolts. One back here, and then the other two are up front. Typically, I'll use a longer extension and just turn the steering a little bit, and you should be able to get to them. Now with that, just need to disconnect the fuel line from the carburetor. Don't be worried if a little bit dribbles out, because there's still gonna be some in that hose from when you turned off the valve. Now, fuel tank, you just lift it by the tail, slide it straight back. Next, we want to get this little plastic pan out of the way. There's just two plastic rivets up toward the front. Then we want to disconnect these, I guess you want to call them cable ties. We've got this reusable end that just snaps in place. Pull the cables out to the side, and you can push up straight at the front to unhook it from the frame, and then just lift it out. Now, what you want to do, let's go ahead and remove the spark plug, because what we're going to do is rotate it around to top dead center. And to do that, having the spark plug out makes it a lot easier to rotate the engine. While we're over here, let's go ahead and remove this valve cover, which will expose the rocker arms and the adjustment points. All right, if your machine is dirty, you want to try to really get it as clean as you can up top before you actually remove that cover, because you don't want dirt falling down in there. Next, there's an access hole right here. It's just a 6 millimeter Allen. And what we're gonna wanna do is open that up. And what I'm gonna do is use a flashlight, and I'm gonna actually pull the engine over very slowly until I see a T mark on the flywheel. Now, keep in mind, there's one right before that T, and it actually is an F. It's not the one you want. You want the T mark. And when you bring around to the T to make sure you're at top dead center on compression, you want to be able to have a little bit of play on your two rocker arms. That'll signify that you're on the compression stroke. And that line that you're aiming for is at the base of the T. And that should be it. Let's reach up here, see if we can rock the arms. Yep, just a little bit. So that tells me that I'm at the compression stroke, top dead center. Now the intake and the exhaust are both set to 6 thousandths or 0.15 millimeters. So either way you want to measure it, that's what you want to go for. All right, using a 10 millimeter, open up your lock nut, make sure it's free. And you want to back off just a tick with a flat blade screwdriver. Slide your feeler gauge in between the actual adjustment nut and the top of the valve. Now you want to bring it down to where it contacts the feeler gauge. Now you want it to have a little bit of pressure to be able to move it back and forth, but you don't want to lock down on it. You still want it to be able to slide ever so slightly. You just want to feel a little bit of a tug on it. All right, once you've got that set, want to put your wrench back on. Most importantly, you want to hold that adjustment screw in the same place. Bring the locking nut down and then tighten it down. And don't let it move, or don't let the adjustment part move. Do the same thing for the other side. Remember, it's the same measurement for the intake and the exhaust. So just slide the gauge in there, bring the adjustment down, and you just want to be able to move it back and forth ever so slightly without it buckling or anything like that. Get your screwdriver back on there, take out the slack, hold the adjuster still, and then tighten it down. Let's go back and check real quick. I can get it in there, move it back and forth. Same thing on both sides. Now, here's when you need to get a torque wrench. We want to set that to 12 foot-pounds. Now there's a chance when I tighten this down or when I torque this down, it may in fact move the adjuster, but we're going to make sure that didn't happen. Let's see, we were pretty close to the 12 foot-pounds. So I didn't have to move it far. Pretty close on that one as well. But I still want to go back and verify that it didn't move any. So I can let go of it and it'll hold it there, but I can pull it out. That's what you're looking for. Well, all right, guys, that's pretty much it. The only thing I need to do now is just put it back together, which is basically the exact reverse of what we did to take it apart. Get our spark plug back in, and the torque on it is going to be 16 foot-pounds. And we're getting our tray in. Remember to bring it all the way forward and get past the frame, and then hook back down on it. A couple of plastic rivets up front. Get our cable holders in place. Now we can get our fuel tank back on. All right, we had the 110 millimeter back at the back. I usually do that one first, and that makes it easier to line up the two up front. Let's go ahead and get the airbox intake tube back in place. Get our plastic rivet back here and retighten this clamp. Get our breather hose back up here and reattach our fuel line to the carburetor. Make sure that little metal clamp is still on there. Now we can reattach this little control arm to the fuel shutoff valve. Turn our fuel back on. Don't forget to put on this little inspection Allen at the back of the engine. All right, last but not least, you need to hook up the battery. This should be the first thing you do and the last thing that you do. Now when you're going in to check and reset the clearance on these, you need to do it with the engine cold. But I can tell you, this one definitely needed to be adjusted because it was ticking like crazy. So, with her put back together, let's fire it off and see what she sounds like. Oh, much better, much better. Well, all right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. This is a very important part of maintenance that you need to keep up with. Well, listen, if you do need any parts for your machine, why don't you come over and see us at Partzilla.com, and I guarantee you we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.